Hi there. So here I have the, get this right, Anengpu LED light strip. This is 5 meters, comes with remote and various other bits and pieces. So best thing is to dig in and have a look at what we've got. So here we have LED strip instruction manual. Well, that's pretty thin on the ground, I would say. Just turn this light on, always forget to turn it on. That's it, one double side of A5. And that's it. Mobile app to control LED strip light for Apple and Android phones. So does it say where to get the app from anywhere? Perhaps there's something else on there. So we have another booklet on a lot. Okay, so this is more about the Lotus. This is Lotus Lantern LED light strip. 20 different static colours, lots of functionality, hopefully software. So I think the software is called Lotus Lantern. We need to have a look at, and there's a QR code there to scan to take you through, hopefully, to the relevant software. So that's much better than that little bit of paper you get. We have a power adapter. We have quite a large remote control. We have a double-sided sticky pad, which I imagine is for attaching the control box to something, if that's what you want to do. And lo and behold, here's the control box with the app again. So this is where the power cable goes in. We've got line of sight remote here, and then we've got the connection. Interesting to see, I always find these connections on these things don't really hold that well in place. It'd be interesting to see how these ones do. These bits are all loose in the box, which is disappointing. Let's tip them out then. We have a couple of connectors here. So you take this part, and I can slot that in there. If that's in the right way, like that. And plug that into the lights. You've got, okay, so we've got some connectors. Now these are designed if you want to cut your light strip, or maybe send it around a corner or something. You can cut it and then join it back up with these little clips. You get two of those. That's quite handy, actually. And then we get obviously another double-sided sticky pad. Put on these pins. We've got two of these pin sets, and of course, then we have the lights themselves. They always come in these foil bags. Going to be a storage thing, I'd imagine. Now, what I'm going to do here is something you really shouldn't do, and that is to actually run the lights on the spool. These are going to go in my daughter's bedroom. We're waiting for a new bed. We just decorated. New bed to turn up, and then I've got to run these along her wardrobe and stuff, so I'm not going to unravel them now. So let's plug in the power cable. I always get excited about lights, I think more so than my kids. There's so many different, what you can do now with LED lights is quite amazing. Particularly we've got the addressable ones, which this isn't one of them, but you can address individual bulbs and things. It's quite amazing. So we're gonna plug that cable into here. And then we've got a connection. So in theory, if I plug this in, they should almost come on straight away or not. To check, got these lined up properly. Arrow going up here. I can just really see this. There's a little tiny little arrow pointing up there, and there's an arrow on here. So we just need to align these two together. And we have lights. There we go. Pop the old remote control out. It's got its pull out tab to engage the battery, and this should be on and off. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to dim the lights. Be much more interesting if I do that. Rather than these blaring lights shining down on the lights we're trying to show. Interesting, I want to check. So they've got time. Yeah. Okay, well, we can run through the controls on this. And I will then download the app as well. So let's pop these lights off and this one off. So we've just got these lights. Pop them on. I'm just flashing across. So obviously I'm now in the dark, but I've got these flashing lights. So we have red, green, blue, and then white. And then we've got 3, 6, 9, 12 preset colors on the remote control. We've got 4 timer buttons, which go up to 12 hours by the looks of it. Then we can dim the lights if we want to, brighten them. Let's go up to full brightness and see what I'm doing here. Then we have some different modes. Oh, it's flashing. There we go. Hello? Ah, look. These are reacting to sound and my voice. These are sound activated. So what you can do, if you play some music, then obviously these are going to jiggle around when you're speaking or the music is playing. Quite cool. Well, then we've got modes. So I should say there were 4 music settings, then we've got 8 modes. Obviously it would show much better if they were strung out rather than being rolled up. And that's all, then we have an auto one. And we're running. So that's pretty good comprehensive remote control. Just going to say a bit more interesting, which are the bits actually connecting with my voice and doing stuff like that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pause the video and I'm going to download the app onto my tablet and we can come back and see how that works with the lights as well. Hi, so I'm just installed the, it's called Lotus Lantern app onto my Android tablet. Open that up, see. Just access my device's location. I suppose so while using the app. And there we are. This is on my tablet, so it's a pretty big layout. We've got our sort of fixed colours at the bottom here, as you can see. And then we've got this choose any colour you like across the whole spectrum, which is quite cool. There's an on-off button at the top, I assume. There we go. So I didn't need to pair anything, actually work with the light straight away, which is pretty cool. You can have some RGB settings in as well, if you want to be a bit more specific. So that's all the basic, then we've got, that's under adjust, we then have style. So there are a whole raft of different settings here, so we can go static purple, 7 colour jumping, 7 colour crossfade, yellow, blue gradual fade, change. So again, loads of preset modes. Blue strobe. What have you got one? Lighted. Blue strobe. All pretty cool. Back to like static red, static blue, etc. So that's style. Now we have got music mode. Now to record audio. Yeah, okay, while using the app. Allow. Okay, I'm just going to choose a track that's, is it actually looking at what's on my tablet? I think so. Let's just play something. Seem to have shut itself down there for no reason, don't know why. So that was music, and then you have a mic option, which is should be picking up what I'm saying. If the light is supposed to do anything. So I've got phone mic or external mic. So we're using basically the phone on my tablet, but it doesn't seem to be doing anything in terms of changing what's going on. Let me play a bit of music on my PC. And let's see how that comes out. So I'm just opening up an app which I can use, which I've got. I don't have to worry about copyright on the music. Much easier. Okay, so let's go find something here. Come on. Don't beep at me. Sound up louder. Okay, so now syncing with the music. Synchronization with the music, can't really complain about that. Let me just stop that for a moment now. Okay, so that's all working absolutely fine. Really pleased with that. Still using the mic, so it's still picking up my voice. The sort of final option you have is a schedule. So you can set up different on-off times, whether it repeats days of the week, etc., which is also quite handy if you want something to come on regularly. So in the scheme of things, you get a decent size remote. Some of these are quite basic. Let me just turn a little bit of light on here. Yeah, so you get a decent remote control with a battery in. You'll see the lights work absolutely fine. They're quite soft and flexible, actually, these ones. Some of them are a bit stiff, but they're not. These are sort of quite soft and move quite pliable. Decent instruction manual, the app's free, we've got some connector pins. We also have, if you want to splice this into smaller sections, which I think my daughter's bedroom, it's going to be like running a sort of underneath the wardrobe. It's one that goes over a bed, so it runs underneath and down the sides. So actually having these will make it really easy for me to just run a strip along the top, cut it, and then run the side bits down and connect it all together. I love the app. The remote's pretty good, but these sort of things really come to life when you're actually using the app that comes with them. It's available on Android and iOS, so it shouldn't be a problem for anyone to get access to it. Music sync's great, lots of colour choices. You know, you can't really complain about these lights. Thanks for watching. Bye.